Hey guys, so it's the start of October 2019 and I have just wrapped up selling for my first month on the Amazon platform in the UK and the EU. And I thought this would be a good opportunity to show you realistically what you can expect to achieve in terms of sales and profit in your first month selling on Amazon. And I thought it was a good opportunity to reflect on some of the successes I've had, some of the mistakes that I've made, the sort of level of passivity that I've been able to achieve in selling on Amazon. So the first thing I'll do is I'll pull up the sales graph itself, which should be on screen now. And what you can see here is that I've been able to make around £1,400 to £1,500 worth of sales in the first month. Around 90 units of products. And just so you know, the kind of setup I have is I have currently three products selling, and those are selling, as you can see, across five different markets: the UK, Germany, France, Italy, and Spain. And how I'm able to achieve this, and how you can achieve this as well, is via a program on Amazon called the EFN, the European Fulfillment Network. What this allows you to do is you can send all of your stock into one European country, and when a customer in a different European country orders via their Amazon, so Amazon France or Amazon Germany, Amazon will actually ship your product from that single country where your stock exists out to a different European country. So in my case, all of my stock is held in the United Kingdom. And if someone from Amazon.de, that's Amazon Germany, sees my product and wants to buy it, Amazon will ship from the UK all the way to Germany in very quick time, a couple of days, something like that, via Prime. So it's a really nice way to immediately expand your opportunity to reach customers. In terms of the products themselves, one is retailing for about $24.99 and the other two are retailing for about $6.99. And the products themselves are Marketplace Superheroes style products. If you're not familiar with Marketplace Superheroes, they are the course that I took to learn all of this Amazon stuff and get started. And I do have a video review of them, which I'll leave a link to in the description and maybe on the video here somewhere. But their approach is basically to find simple and boring household garden items that are already selling well on Amazon and basically make an improved offer and sell those to customers. So you know there's existing demand and it's something really simple and not complicated. So all my three products are that kind of style, and the business model itself is to basically expect to only sell a few units, but of many products in many different marketplaces. And that's how you scale and grow your business. So rather than expecting one product to carry your entire business and make hundreds of sales a day, you just get more products, only selling a few a day, and scale that up across multiple markets. So that's the business model. It's kind of what you can see here. I've got three products selling in five different marketplaces, which is 15 opportunities to make a sale to a customer on any given day. One thing to note is that Amazon Sponsored Products, which is Amazon's advertising platform, has been really important in the first month. If you think of how you act as a customer when you come onto Amazon, certainly for myself, what you do is you come to Amazon's homepage, you type in a search describing the item that you want to buy, you click go, you see a page of results, and you'll look through that page and you'll select an item and you'll buy it and you'll be done. The problem when you start on Amazon is obviously you do not start on the first page. You start somewhere way down the bottom, page 50, page 20, page 100, whatever it is. And so it can be very hard to get customers' eyes on your product, even if it's the best product in the world. If no one can see it, then you're never going to make any sales. So what Amazon Sponsored Products allows you to do is you pay Amazon a little bit of money for it to be featured in an advertisement, and that advertisement will show up on the first page at the very top. So it's like the prime place for customers to see and get interested in your product. And what I've found, I can share some screenshots of the data, is that the initial sales are very much driven by these sponsored product ads. So I think it's really important to get those set up initially, because what this means is that every time someone buys your item, it's going to increase your organic rank of that product. And what does that mean? Well, it means that your real listing, not your advertisement, but your actual listing, is going to move up through those pages towards the front page. The more sales you make, the higher that's going to go. Amazon basically promotes the most popular and best items to the top. So by driving this traffic through advertisements, your organic product listing is going to be creeping up towards the front page. And eventually, when it gets to the front page, you would expect more organic sales, a bigger proportion of organic sales relative to paid sales. The other thing to say, which I think some other people are a little bit misleading about, is that they present these sales numbers back as, oh, this is what I made selling on Amazon. And it's not really true. I mean, these are revenue numbers, which is obviously different from profit. So this is the raw amount of sales that you've made to a customer. But obviously you have to take into account that your product costs something to make, it costs money to ship, it costs money to package, it costs money to hold at a warehouse before sending to Amazon, all this sort of stuff. So realistically, out of this revenue that I've made, around 30% of this is going to be profit. So just be aware of that, that the numbers that you see here are not money that I can put in my pocket and walk away with and buy something with. There are costs of doing business and costs associated with the product, and only what's left will be the profit. Based on any preconceived ideas you might have about other channels that you've looked at, other sellers you're aware of, this might look really great, or this might look really disappointing to you. I don't know, it'll depend on what you've seen before, but what I would say is I think this is a realistic expectation to have. And for me, if 30% of this is profit, then that's about enough to cover the fixed cost of running the business. Things like having my accounting done every month, paying my Amazon subscription fees, paying software licenses for various pieces of software that I use to help me out. And so for me that's great, because up until now I've been putting my own money in just to cover that. So now that that can be covered by the business itself, any more money that I put in can actually go towards new products. And when I invest in products and sell products, by the time those products sell out, I'll have doubled my money. That's the kind of products I'm looking to get. So having a baseline where the business covers itself, and then any additional cash injection can be doubled really quickly, and then doubled again, means that from this point, the business is set to grow really nicely, really quickly. So I'm really happy with that, and I hope you guys can see that this is a a realistic start to a business, not a $0 to $1 million overnight that a lot of people will tell you is possible. In terms of how passive the business has been, there's a lot of work up front, doing research, contacting suppliers, raising capital, all that sort of stuff. But once the product's actually got into stock, the process has been extremely passive. Like I said before, you have to respond to customer messages every day. I haven't had any, that's been great. If your product's running low on stock, you just need to keep an eye on that. Know when to reorder with your supplier or replenish from your pre-Amazon location. And also monitor your sponsored product advertising campaigns every week or so. Other than that, I'm not touching these goods at all, I'm not doing any manual labor, so it is super passive. In terms of mistakes and challenges along the way, one thing I'd say is I shipped all my products by sea, which is the most cost-effective and best long-term solution. However, what I probably should have done is had a single unit of each of the finished products air-shipped to myself so that I was able to get the photography done while the rest of the goods were at sea. What I actually did was just wait until the sea shipment arrived, went to the pre-Amazon location, then had those sent to the photographer, had to wait 2 weeks, and then only when those were done could I send the goods to Amazon. So there was around a 2 week period where I could have been selling and I wasn't selling because I didn't have my product photography done. That would have cost me a little bit more out of my pocket, especially since one of my items is a bit heavier and that would be quite expensive to airship. So it's, I don't know, six and half a dozen. I would have been losing a little bit of money but starting to make sales earlier, whereas I started making sales later but saved myself a bit of money. Another mistake I made in one of my listings was there was a box, I'll bring it up on screen, that said, what is the target audience for your product? And I didn't think too much about this, but I believe it gave you the option of adult and child, and I selected the box adult. And then what I didn't realise for a whole couple of weeks was that all of my advertising campaigns were being suppressed. And as I said before, that means that you basically get no eyes on your product at the start because it's not on page one and it's not visible organically. From what I can tell, they must be suppressing the advertising because anything flagged with that adult flag is like, I don't know, a bit sexy or inappropriate for children or something like that. So that's something to be wary of when you're creating your listing. Don't just tick boxes that seem intuitively right to you. Go and actively check with Amazon if you're not sure. And avoid doing what I did and ticking the wrong box and causing problems for yourself. One other issue I had was that I ran out of stock in Amazon of one of my products, but not because I hadn't ordered enough overall, but because I didn't trigger a replenishment order from my pre-Amazon location in time. So just so you're familiar with my setup, I will order a large number of units from a supplier in China and I'll have them delivered to a warehouse location in the UK. And then periodically I will get some of the units from that warehouse sent into Amazon ready to sell. And the reason for doing that is the storage costs are cheaper in the warehouse, and if I want to have any work done on the products, like I want to have them relabeled, reboxed, repackaged, maybe something goes wrong in one of my shipments from China, I can get that fixed before I send it to Amazon. All your duties and VAT and all that is sorted and not involving Amazon. Basically, it's just a lot cleaner way to do things. But I underestimated the amount of time it could take to go from the pre-Amazon location to Amazon, and so I ended up out of stock. It was for around maybe 3 days, something like that. But that was my bad, and I've kind of borne that in mind, and I know to replenish a little bit earlier to give them the time they need. And the last thing I want to talk about in terms of mistakes is probably the biggest cliche when it comes to Amazon sellers, but it's true, and that is cash flow. In terms of starting this business, I was pretty aggressive in terms of, like, I've got this amount to invest, I'm going to really just squeeze as much as I can out of that, get multiple products, order a decent size of each one of those, get translations done, get professional photography done, all that sort of stuff, which meant that I didn't have a lot of working capital left. And what that meant was that for one of my products I only ordered just over 200 units, and because there's a 3 month lead time from China to the UK when doing sea shipping, if I sold about one per day, then I would sell out in 3 months and I would be out of stock. So I was very aware that as soon as I start making sales, I need to monitor the rate at which that's happening. If I'm getting one sale a day or more than one sale a day, then I need to be on it and I need to reorder with the supplier. However, Amazon only reimburses you every couple of weeks, and when you start, they often don't reimburse you right away. So your payments are delayed, they withhold some funds in case people return items and things like that. So you just don't have the cash flow available to you. And so I basically was scraping together money from different sources to try and do this reorder. And the reorder I did is probably not going to be enough. It's around the same size as my initial order, which in reality means I'm probably going to run out of stock on my initial order and my reorder, which is a little bit disappointing, but it's kind of inevitable when you start unless you've got a big pot of money. And the only thing I can really do is learn from that going forward. And ultimately, in the long term, what I want to be looking at doing is using outside finance to cover the cost of buying the goods from the supplier and then paying back that loan and taking profit from the ultimate sale of those goods. Again, I can go into that in a bit more detail in another video, but that should help with some of these cash flow problems. So in terms of next steps, the three things I really want to get going are, I've got two products waiting in the wings that, lo and behold, cash flow is a bit of a problem, but I want to get them launched as soon as I can. The other thing is I really want to expand into the US market. The customer base in the US is approximately the same size as the entirety of Europe. So in theory, I should be able to double revenue by taking the products I've got in the UK and also launching them in the US. So that's something I'm really keen on getting done soon. And the third thing is to invest in my business by getting brand registered. What this means is registering my brand name as a trademark and going through the brand registration process on Amazon. And what that allows you to do is, I mean, Amazon just see you as more professional for a start. If you've got any problems with hijackers on your listing or any of those kind of things, Amazon can sort those out, turn it around within 24 hours. And you also get opportunities to improve your listings through enhanced brand content. If you've ever gone down to a description in a listing and it's had loads of nice images and whatnot, looks a bit like a web page, things like that become accessible to you. And I think you may also be able to add a video to your list of images on your listing. So that's definitely something I want to look at and something that's going to be a hugely beneficial long-term investment in my business. So I want to get that going. So that's really it, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this realistic, honest look at what a first month's sales on Amazon looks like. And I hope it's inspired you in some way to get started doing this yourself. For me, it's been life-changing. It's a source of passive income. I'm learning loads at the same time. I'm in control of how my money is being invested and growing. It's just been a hugely empowering process. I hope it inspires you to do the same. If you are interested in getting started on Amazon yourself, then I would recommend that you follow a really good training program to get started. There are lots of potential mistakes to make at the start, and if you get started in the wrong way, it can be quite hard to correct later, and you are investing potentially multiple thousands of dollars getting a business like this started, so you really don't want to get it wrong. The training program I used, as I've mentioned before, is Marketplace Superheroes. I do highly recommend that course. It's what I went through and how I got the results that I've got and how I'm working with them to scale my business going forward. I like them. I think the course is great. I do recommend it. If you want to check it out via my particular link, then that'll be down in the description. That is an affiliate link, which means that if you sign up via the link, I get a kickback. I get rewarded monetarily for it. That is not the reason I'm giving you the link. I genuinely believe in the course, and as you can see, I am actively working with them. But it helps support the channel, it helps me build my business and drive my business forward. So if you do want to sign up via that link, I would really appreciate it. I would say at least go check them out anyway. You can get a 7-day free trial if you go through that link below. And they also do have a 30-day money-back guarantee, so if you go through the course and you really decide it isn't for you, for whatever reason, they will refund your money, no problem. So whether you go with Marketplace Superheroes or you go with a different course like Amazing Selling Machine if your budget's a bit bigger, just pick a course that's right for you and it's going to teach you what you need to get started. Either way, that's the end of the video today. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch it. If you found the content valuable, then please go ahead and give the video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you want to see more content like this in the future. And hit the bell notification icon so that every time I release a new video, you'll get notified via a notification and you'll be able to watch that right away. So thank you for your support, and I will see you in the next one.